Ito ang nakakagulat na balita. University of the Philippines, matigas ang ulo. Ayaw sundin si President Bongbong Marcos. Pati di umano mga senador, nagalit na sa administrasyon ng University of the Philippines. Matigas na ang ulo ng mga students. Matigas din daw di umano ang mga ulo pati president at professor sa UP. Ayaw daw nila ng face-to-face class na gustong gawin ng gobyerno. Halata din daw na mga spoiled ang mga students at mga opisyal sa loob ng university. Kaya dapat na sigurong linisin or kaya naman ipasara na ang bulok na university na ito. Halatang dilawan na di umano ang namumuno dahil ayaw sundin si Pangulong Marcos at Vice President Sara Duterte.
Estudyanteng ayaw mag face to face, hindi namin sila po pwedeng iwanan. So kinakailangan din naming mag-offer ng online. May mga teachers na ayaw magturo hanggat ng face to face, hanggat hindi natatapos ang pandemya. Hindi pa natatapos ang pandemya, wala pang deklarasyon ang WHO, natapos na ito. Sa madalit sabi, pwede nilang sabihin hindi po kami magtuturo ng face to face. Parurusahan ko ba ang teacher na yan na ayaw magturo ng face-to-face? Pwede ko bang lagyan ng sanctions yan? Pwede bang sabihin tatanggalin kita? Sa madalit sabi, kung may mga estudyante na gustong mag-aral ng face-to-face, ipe-face-to-face namin sila. At kung walang mga guro na employed namin ngayon ang willing magturo, hahanap kami ng ibang teacher na magtuturo sa kanila. Sa madalit sabi, walang estudyante na maggusto ng face-to-face class ang hindi makakapag face-to-face class sa UP. Kung may teacher na ayaw magturo ng face-to-face, hanggat may pandemya, hindi namin sila po pwedeng parusahan, ma'am. Okay, pero hahanapan namin sila ng trabaho. At kung walang magtuturo ng klase nila, hahanap kami ng teacher na magtuturo ng klase nila. Sa madalit sabi, pagdating ng second semester, ma'am, walang estudyanteng magre-reklamo na gusto niya mag-face-to-face ay hindi siya nakapag-face-to-face.
Yeah. Madam Chair, may I?
And I just wanted to say that I wish you had done that earlier because even though WHO has not declared that the pandemic is over, WHO and the rest of the world, and even this country has declared that we are living with COVID. We go to movies. We watch basketball games. Punong-puno ang stadium. Pag naglalaro ang UP, naglalaro ang Lasal, Ateneo, lahat na po, UST, Senator Joel will get mad if I do not mention his alma mater. Lahat nagagawa face-to-face. Kung bakit naiwan ang UP, nasa sa inyo na po yun. Kayo naman po ang educator. I am just mentioning
Madam
that
Chair,
as a legislator, job ko na alamin kung ano ba ang nasasaad sa inyong charter, kung ano ba ang mga budgetary requirements ng buong state university system para makita naman natin saan tayo makakasupport. If you do not believe that it is urgent that these students are face-to-face, decision nyo na po yun. Ako naman, it's just my job to point out what I have observed, that others have been able to go to face-to-face. And I am not done, but I will give the floor to Senator Alang.
Well, Madam Chair, I'll start with your...
Can I, Senator Alang? Okay. Senator Pia, you were one of my best students. And we value. We value all the comments that you have given us in the last hearing. And you know, I barged into the meeting of the Executive Committee of Diliman just to bring out all the points that were discussed in the last hearing that we had.
In all things, pero let's not go there right now. I just want to put on record, again, like I said, it's not my job to lecture the learned people in this hearing, no? But I cannot help but rely on what I read, no? And there's one study by Kokolt et al., dated 2021, it's straight to the point. When streamed, and so we're talking about online, when streamed lectures substitute for no attendance, they can help students. But when streaming lectures substitute for in-person attendance, they can hurt students. I don't think we have to argue with that, Mr. President. Let the record show, Chair Popoy nodded, President Danny Concepcion nodded. So, yun ang gusto ko, no, na not just the best of our SUCs, but all the SUCs recognize this and move towards that. If and I sadly, Mr. President, I'm not as I don't know what's the word I'm looking for, political as my brother, politically correct as my brother. I do hope that UP will find a way to do it this semester. I do hope that you can find teachers, and I'm sure there are out there who are willing to say, ako magvo-volunteer ako mag face to face.
And that's a commitment, ma'am.
Thank you. Because Chancellor Padilla, and again, face to face kami nag-discuss, and it mattered, it helped. Magkaintindihan, you know, she says she understood my frustration. She also made certain commitments to me because I just want these students to have that experience, whether they're a freshman, what a way to start your freshman year. And whether they're graduating, what a way to graduate that you never even saw your classmates, no? You never got a pat on the back after your teacher made you sermon. All you'll get is a virtual thumbs up from your classmates or a virtual thumbs down. Nakakaawa naman if this is the life that they have. And we didn't do what we could to address that. Again, even for a few thousand graduating students this semester or a few thousand incoming freshmen this semester. So you gave me your word. I can
yes.
That's my case.
Now,
But sorry, President Nani, later on, I don't want to keep everybody here who's not,
Madam
doesn't
Chair,
have to be here.
Can a different but, issue?
Because I want to be sure, because I will again have to defend this on the floor, your chancellors are also giving me their word on this. Kasi mahirap naman na you're giving me your word, tapos sasabihin nila sa inyo, ba't mo kami kinomit? Di naman pwede sa amin yan. So I want to hear from them if they will make this happen also.
Diba? Pero ang commitment ko is we will try our best to do it this year.
And I have known you to try your best and make it happen. Kahit na 7 taon inabot na hindi mo kasalanan, hindi mo inumpisahan ang football field na inabot ng mga 4 na taon, tapos wag daw gamitin ng mga bata kasi okay na si football field, pero patawarin ang track oval, inabot din at you had to fire. You had to fire the contractor. Altogether, mga 7 taon. So,
tapos na, ma'am.
Nga. So, I said, when you tell me now, your only commitment to me is you will try, naniniwala ako na in every campus, makakahanap ka ng teacher na may gusto magturo. At wag natin pag-usapan yung sciences kasi God bless their souls. Nagtuturo na yung mga teachers na yon dati pa. I'm sure may GE teachers din naman na gusto magturo. And again, let me be very clear. Wala naman akong sinabi na yung may comorbidity or hindi talaga kayang magturo, magturo. Naiintindihan ko naman yung restrictions that you have. But I will give you a copy of a document from NUS, National University of Singapore, wherein they laid out, in one page, na layout nila yung very simple nilang directions on face-to-face. The rule is face-to-face. There are no excuses other than positive ka. Hindi ka makapasok. There's no other excuses. Let's all go face-to-face. Blended will be extended to the extent na kailangan because hindi ka nga makakapasok dahil positive ka. Tama ba yun? Something to that effect, di ba? There were not 101 excuses. Kasi nung unang hearing, meron pang magsasabi sa akin, di naman po UP lang, iba pa. And I don't even know if you mentioned it. Walang dorm. Matagal ng problem yan. And it is not fair na walang dorm. But I am very willing to fight for that on the Senate floor na lahat ng ready na nag-request ng dorm, ma-prioritize yung dorms. But don't tell me that's the reason na nag-online tayo kasi those are problems that we can work around. So yun lang naman yung...
Madam Chair.
Thank you.
Well, Madam Chair, let me put on record first.
Thank you din kasi I have to say thank you to my professor. Napakadami kong natutunan sa kanya. Nag-survive ako ng first year ng family law sa kanya and I knew after that I will survive UP Law. Kaya ako din, grabe ang pasasalamat ko sa inyo personally and sa mga naging teacher ko. Kaya ganun na lang naman, nag-aabala akong to give my little input, even though I am just a humble lawyer and not an educator, kung ano yung mga observations ko at ano yung nakita ko. Kasi like I said, ako yung magdi-defend ng budget ng UP. Ako yung nagsasabi kung bakit mas malaki yung budget ng UP, pabayaan natin, dinadagdagan ko pa. Kaya naman, karapatan ko din to ask na wala naman sanang ma-o-offend na tinatanong ko kasi I will be asked on the floor, bakit mas malaki yung budget ng UP? Bakit tuloy-tuloy na mas malaki? Bakit hindi sila makapag face-to-face? Yun lang naman po yung sa akin.
Well, Madam Chair, you know, I'm happy that nagmi-meet yung minds ko, ano yung issue and finding a solution. But I'd like to support you na, number one, I'm one of those senators that she'll have to defend it from. Because, although I've done...
Tanggalin yung, hinahanap niya ang budget ng, na ginagamit ng UPA, tatanggalin na daw niya kasi hindi naman kayo nagpapa-upcut. And I go through that all the
time. May I continue, Madam Chair, before you...
Gusto ko lang sabihin kasi na kahit ikaw inaaway kita na huwag mong galawin yung budget ng UP, dagdagan pa natin. Yeah.
Nadagdagan tuloy yung i-explain ko. I think I've done my part for UP. I was the chair of the Education Committee nung pinasa yung Centennial Charter Change ng UP. It was my staff who came up with yung 100 million for 5 years na Centennial Fund, pero to compromise na hindi pwedeng ibenta yung mga lupa ng UP. We found a win-win, and you know, all of us here na taga UP, I think we love our alma mater, we're willing to do so much, no? But ang point ko, as a former chair din ng Committee on Education, nung magkasama pa yung DepEd, CHED, and TESDA under one committee. Talagang pag tinignan mo peso per peso, 'di ba? It's just like Philippine science versus the other science schools, 'di ba? Na you expect more because per student they're getting much more. At yung chart kanina na 25%, that's quite accurate, but before it was even bigger. Before mas malaki talaga. And of course, like PUP noon did not have that many students. So the point I was going to make is one, that you do have to defend sa iba, lalo sa hindi taga-UP ko. Ako taga-UP na, ang feeling ko pa na peso per peso, why shouldn't I give more to PUP? And full disclosure, humingi kasi ako ng board seat sa PUP sa kay Senator Cheese, no, which I thank him for. You know, try to do a little bit better. Try to do some good naman in another university, no. So I felt strongly about the UPCAT because if other universities have put back their entrance exam, tama ka naman. I mean, di naman nag-go 100,000. But as I told you, again, when we say you, sir, we mean the whole board, no? Hindi naman ikaw lang. I mean, kahit naman iutos mo yun, kung hindi nila gagawin. Diba? So having said that, 300,000 ngayon sa civil service. So one, I felt strongly about the UPCAT. Especially because nga we had people in our science high schools, not only in Philippine science, but in our own science high schools, na pangarap talaga nila. And I can tell you, dun sa Senator Rene Cayetano Science and Technology High School, iba talaga mag-grade. Kasi it's so competitive. So talagang, kumbaga, kung valedictorian salutatorian ka, ikaw yung may 90. Pero, I don't want to tell you what college, but diba nung tayo nasa college, alam natin kung saan madaming cum laude at hindi. It doesn't mean that they're smarter sa iba, but may ibang college talaga na, I think UP Law, bihira, suma cum laude ata, wala, di ba? Oo, but may suma sa iba. Doesn't make them less of a suma cum laude, di ba?
I just want to point out for our colleagues, no? This was a slide again of PASOK that showed the per capita cost of educating a student. So the average is 51,000. Is this per sem or per year? Per year naman ito, no? Per year. The lowest is 18,000. Laki ng difference. So with the highest, which is UP, 368,000, 390,000.
Which is more than the tuition fee of Ateneo and LaSalle. Or more or less.
Pero just to be clear, no, meron pang another number below it, 270, which says UP system excluding PGA. So even if you use the 270, ako nga yung nagdi-defend ng UP budget. Ako nga yung nagja-justify kung bakit kailangan pa natin bigyan pa ng budget and UP. So siguro naman, you can also understand why I want to see, at least from my perspective as a legislator, not as an educator, I want to understand why is UP not at the forefront in returning to face-to-face? Because the problems that you mentioned, Mr. President, are also problems that the other SUCs also had. Merong estudyante na malayo, umuwi, hindi makabalik. Merong teachers na may sakit, merong may comorbidity, merong retirable na yun din, may comorbidity, and so on and so forth. Lahat naman po may ganyan mga problema. So, I would like to now read into the record.
Madam Chair, that was my last point. But since you interrupted me, so I'll make the last point, di ba? The last point, President Danny, was precisely that, na now na nalinaw na yung definition ng blended is may 75%. I think dun kayo hindi nakikita eye to eye dun sa sinasabi niyang hindi niya kinikonsider kasi yung blended. Kapag kayong estudyante, nagkataon man pero nangyayari, 100% online, which I think you agree with. Na pag 100% online, hindi blended. No, that's why I'm clarifying it now. Allow me to clarify it now. So you do agree, di ba, na pag 100% online lang yon, hindi blended yon.
Hindi po ganun ang definition namin eh.
Oo.
Kapag ka po online, pero meron siyang synchronous at asynchronous, ang pagkaka-define namin doon blended. Siguro tama kayo, baka dapat doon blended online.
Oo. Yeah, anyway, now that Chad, so that we don't debate kasi past na yan eh, ika nga, di ba? All of us.
Sa past, present siya.
Yeah.
It is happening now.
Yeah, but you cannot change it in the middle of the sem. Eh. So in that sense, di ba? So we're talking about next sem. We're all clear naman here that the guidelines ngayon, subject to you reading the guidelines, is that dapat may 75%. And I think that's the better rule because if it's per teacher or per class, pwede talagang mangyari na yung lahat ng in-enrollan mo that sem, online ka. Di ba? Oo. So I mean, just to put a seal on that issue, and again, no, I UP continues to be the leader in many aspects. But I guess that's what the chairperson was looking for in terms of the face to face, no.
Madam Chair.
Yes.
Yeah.
Chairman Popot.
Even when the pandemic was a little better under control, we already mobilized our technical panel on flexible learning to start reviewing the 75-25, etc. Because we're encouraging the schools to really invest in technology, invest in alternative ways of doing it. And as the things move on, we can be more flexible to encourage universities to do technology-mediated learning. But I agree with you, we have to bring them to the classroom.
But Chair, the new development here kasi is DepEd, di ba? So kung yung labor department sinasabing, di ba, payagan namin yung ibang call center na from home, but basically, malaya na kayong pumasok, wala nang restriction sa offices, then DepEd is saying, all ages, pumasok na kayo. Siyempre, magiging weakest link ngayon dyan, yung higher education, kung dadating sa point na may full online pa rin tayo, but we'll consider that not distance learning. But I think we're in agreement ngayon. So the only thing is, how do we come up, or CHED comes up with something that is the best for students in terms of percentage ng face-to-face, but taking into consideration the present problems you're saying, older teachers that might necessarily be safe sa classroom, yung overpopulated state universities and everything, no? The reason, Madam Chair, na I want you, President Danny, and CHED chairperson to be less stressed is ang dami pa rin natin ibang problema sa budget. So, I mean, I do agree na apex problem tong face-to-face, no? But ang dami nating iba pang problema. Yung facilities, if I may bring up one, no? It might be a problem of planning, or it might be a problem ng wala kasing yearly guaranteed fund and CHED at state universities for facilities. So hindi katulad ng school building program na since the Rojas Law, or even before that, every year meron na yan. Diba? It's just a matter of the absorptive capacity, or it's not like PGH that after I think 5-year period, diba, na binuhusan ng pera, nagkaroon ng better facility. So ang question ngayon, maintenance, no? But most of our universities are begging for funds for new school buildings, for gyms, for ovals, etc. No? And I think, Madam Chair, that's one thing that in a start of a new administration, it's good to bring up. Do we want to continue to do the budgeting of state universities like this, na kanya-kanyang lakad sa kailangan niyang facilities, or as a nation, one nation approach, all of government approach, you know, we should put some money in SHED and then pagalingan sila ng planning para hingin sa commission na, I mean, of course, if their individual governors, mayors, congressmen want to build there, why not? But I'm talking about an institutional approach to planning and building all of these facilities, no?
Just for the record, I have a bill, the Priority Infrastructure for SUCs bill, which indicated an amount of 25 billion over 5 years. Not big, but it's a starting point. Unfortunately, in the consolidated bill yata, which is a draft committee report, natanggal yung amount. But but we're talking of the same objective, no? You wanted to give you a lump sum, and I've had this discussion with Secretary Mina of DBM na wag naman na, let's not let them beg every year, di ba? Let's set aside an amount for education. It's the same argument I had for school buildings, for DepEd, and then for SUCs, kung ano man yung mga capital outlay requirement nila. Because we're obviously going to play catch up for at least 10 years or 30 years? I don't know. With 5 billion a year, wala yan. Mga 30 years pa siguro, kulang pa. Bill pala namin. Okay. Co-author ko pala siya. Ako co-author mo? Hindi. Anyway, this is a private discussion. are you done? Are you okay?
No, I just wanted to emphasize that that's an important, so I thank all of you for exhausting that. But yun nga, ang dami natin pang positive na pwedeng ayusin together sa budget. So I thank you, Madam Chair, for, you know, spending time on this. And see, na-solve natin to kasi face-to-face tayo.
It is easier
kasi yung bulungan
discuss
on the side and yung, yeah, kamayan and yung...
Exactly.
Is important.
I agree. I would...
Sa Dr. Gabs, thank you for phone calls, interceding, and continually advising us on.
He's a neurosurgeon, but he's like my psychologist.